Hey everyone, this is Nick. I wanted to jump on for this quick viewer question video. We got a viewer question over here from Sarah Hafer, and this was on one of our videos on how to connect Excel to Microsoft Forms. She asked a really specific question about a question that she put into her form that was sort of this multiple checkbox or select all that apply question, and she created that. She got an export into Excel with all of the options selected on the form concatenated into one cell in one column, and they were each of the options were separated by a semicolon. So she wanted to know if there's a way to sort of reformat that semicolon concatenated list into something that looks a little bit more well formatted with some spaces in it. And so I wanted to show you, Sarah, over here, we can do this, and it's just going to take us a couple little functions. We're going to have to go through a couple little functions and formulas to make this happen. So you can see this is going to be the end output that we have. So this is the first output from Microsoft Forms. You have your list of category selections, and they're all separated by a semicolon there, but there's no space after the semicolon, and Sarah wanted a space after the semicolon here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through a process of splitting up the text into columns. So each of those text, each of those items that's separated by the semicolon, we're going to separate into individual columns, individual cells through columns, and then we're going to join them back together, but we're going to create a special join element in that we are going to make that semicolon and a space after it be the joiner to rejoin the text. So these are two array formulas that Microsoft 365 users will have. I hope that you have access to them. There are some other ways that we could do this if you don't have access to these functions, but I'm pretty sure most people these days have these new functions, TEXTSPLIT and TEXTJOIN. So let's go over here to our data sheet right here, and let's just go through this process. Right here, we have our output from Microsoft Forms in column A, and in column B, this is where we're going to split the text. So I'm just going to go ahead and type in my function equals text split, and then open the parentheses, and I'm going to point to the cell that I want to split up. It's going to be this one in A2. I'm going to put a comma here, and then it asks me for the column delimiter. So what am I going to split up this text by? And I'm going to say the semicolon. So I'm going to do that with a quotation mark, and then the semicolon, and then another quotation mark here. And so this is saying that I'm going to split whatever text is in cell A2. It's going to split it up by into columns every time there's a semicolon. So I'm going to close the parenthesis here and push enter and see what happens. Now you can see that it split everything up and it's gotten rid of our semicolon. So we have elementary school, medical, and then high school as our options there. Now this is an array formula. So you notice here when I put my cursor, I highlight this cell here in B2, that all of the other words here are kind of spilled over into this range. But if I put my cursor into C2, there's not actually anything in here. This is kind of a grayed out. It's a kind of a grayed out function right there. It's telling us that this is an array formula, an array function. That's totally okay. But I want you to know that you're going to copy this formula down into B, into column, all the rows in column B, and we're not going to worry about the cells in column C, D, E, F, G, however many columns these will split into. I think there's a potential here of 6, but I think you had a potential of 14. So in column B right here, just go ahead and double click. And actually, double click didn't work. So what we're going to do is we're going to click and drag down to copy this formula down, this function down, all the way down to however many rows you have. And I'm just going to put it right there. And now you can see that it has spilled everything. It's split every single thing in column A over into all of the columns right here. Now, if I wanted to use my arrow keys, shift arrow over, and then shift arrow down, let's see, all the way down to my last cell right here, it looks like, I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to Control C, and now I'm going to do Control Shift V to paste as values. And now when I do that, you can see in all of these cells, the value of the word, the item, is in those cells. And you can see up here in the formula bar, we don't have that array formula anymore, that text join. So you can do this, and just that may make things a little bit easier, a little cleaner on your end. But the next step here is that we want to join all of these into our new formatting. So over here in column H, I'm going to go ahead and we're going to use the text join function. So I'm going to join all of these texts together. So we're going to say equals text join. open the parenthesis. Now I have to decide what delimiter I want to join them with. And this is where we're gonna do our custom semicolon. So I'm gonna say open quotation mark, semicolon, and then put a space in here. And then we're going to close the quotation mark. Now that's gonna tell us that we're gonna put a semicolon with a space in between each of the words that we're joining together. I'm gonna go ahead and put a comma here, and I'm gonna say true. I'm gonna make sure that this true is selected. We're gonna ignore any of the empty cells. That's what we wanna do there. And then I'm gonna put another column, and now I'm going to drag across G all the way back to column B. All of the cells that you want to join together, we're gonna put here. We're gonna close the parenthesis there to make that function perfect, that formula perfect. I'm gonna push enter, and now everything has been joined together, elementary school, semicolon, space, medical, etc. And the same thing I'm gonna do, I'm going to go ahead and take my cursor and drag that all the way down to copy, all the way down. Perfect. Oops, all the way up there. Got to go back up. There we are. And now we have a perfectly reformatted cell. Now, this text join formula is also a little bit of a tricky thing here. So if you wanted to copy this, you could just go ahead, shift control down arrow, control C, and control shift V to paste as values. And now if you look in those cells, there's no more formula in there. This is just, we just pasted the value. So if you wanted to work with that in any other way, you could do that instead of having that function there. So Sarah, I hope that this helps. I think this is gonna be a pretty quick trick to get your formatting sort of concatenated in the way that you want with a nice little semicolon and a space. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, but sometimes Excel or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.